Yeah, Oscar's still on holidays.
Yeah, last day of holidays, I'm enjoying the most of it. I'm really surprised we're allowed to walk in. Walk in the paddock with flip-flops or thong. I didn't actually know we were coming to the track as my excuse. Here I was thinking I'd just be going to a hotel room, but no. My friend's the whole F1 world.
Oh!
Hello.
Who's that?
Yeah. I didn't actually know I was coming here, so I'm a bit underdressed. I could very easily jump in the pool right now with this, yeah.
Okay. Now is that the space of the weekend? That's perfect.
Fish! 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 Push! Buono e concentrato? Vediamo di vedere.
Except the two. The highlight of Monza so far. Hopefully it's the first highlight of many.
So guys, this is dessert of René. He left somewhere. While he left.
Secret weapon for the weekend.
After the Nutella.
After the Nutella, yeah. There's a lot of secret weapons this week.
So we went in the autostrada, like autogrill stuff, to eat something on the way. Michele,
finish,
look at
your
me.
Panna cotta, please.
No, I'm just tempting you a bit more. So Michele stopped in and look at me with Nutella stuff and says, "This is for us." So I'm saying, "Yeah, good idea." So me, I start to eat, and then came the last two ones. He looked at the tube and he's like, "But fuck you! You ate everything." It was for Oscar. What? No, you didn't say that.
So you did him a favor.
Yes.
Ciao.
We were laughing at the fact that he had three pieces of it.
There is not the sugar crunchy on top.
So the fact that it was already eaten before by someone.
I know it was one of you, so that's not a problem.
The vanilla ice cream, I took one scoop.
That's what they can eat.
And?
It is very difficult because I cannot smile, otherwise it falls down.
I am the original. The French people are weird sometimes.
What is this?
We're funny.
Are you D'Artagnan? Like family of D'Artagnan?
There is no way you act like that. The idea of a proper setup for Monza is mine at the beginning. So
Who tried to do the real moustache first? I did.
Who tried the Monza setup first?
Yeah, I did!
No,
you are nothing without
me. It was
nothing.
Last week, mate.
Athos, Portos, Aramis.
Bah, du coup, je suis celui Aramis.
Quoi?
Moi, je suis Athos. Athos, ça fait un peu genre dieu grec.
Athos, ça fait un peu personnage d'Astérix.
Est-ce que ça veut dire quelque chose en grec ou pas, Athos?
Oui, ça veut dire débile. C'est la Thassos,
ouais. Non, c'est Rassos. Un truc comme ça, non? C'est pas ça?
Ouais. Tu parles vachement bien grec en fait, hein?
Ouais. Kalimera, Kalispera, Tikanis. Kala, ici. C'est D'Artagnan, c'est Guillaume. C'est le chef, quoi. Ah, mais attends, il faut regarder le film. Parce qu'Athos, c'est pas le gros.
Ah, c'est toi alors?
Parce que moi, je veux pas être Depardieu. Hein. Ouais, sinon, il y a le religieux aussi. Attends, il faut que je regarde.
Stupido.
Like the fastest one ever.
But he has a lot of margin on exit, it's not like middle of the curve, yeah, but sitting traction.
Yeah, but traction is very important. If you put...
Anywhere?
Yeah. Have a nice day.
Thank you, you too.
Hi.
Phil, 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 Phil.
No, we need more, but not enough that it breaks my back. Just a little bit of.
You can do it with the radio if you want.
Oh yeah. But you have so sector two, you need 1/10, and sector three, you need another 2/10. Over.
The problem is that I have to do it exactly at the same time every lap.
Yeah.
Because if you use that as a reference for braking, we might have an issue.
So it started from like when I was like 6 years old. I took that design and yeah, straight away it was bringing me really good results. Good results. It was looking good. Everybody could recognize me. In Italy, like in the karting, they were always calling me the gold helmet. They could really see me out of the back because, you know, when there is a lot of pack in karting, they need to recognize who is who. And plus, my dad I sort of help. It's like flower business. You can still see the flowers here, the gold, the main color.
Thank you for making me laugh in the middle of things that depress me.
See? Make people laugh, that's the important thing.
There you go, follow him. Do not follow me.
I wonder what you have on TikTok.
I did one, it took me about 2 hours to make. I was like, I will make this happen. Yeah. It was almost midnight.
Yeah, I had some TikToks which took a bit of time. I had the same thing.
You need to teach me.
Like every time you're like, a little bit it's going off again and again and again.
And then you see people posting every day, you're like, how do they do that? Do they have so much time to waste?
Yeah.
And you watch it and then you hate yourself. So there you go. Robert Shwartzman, here we are in Monza, but it's been a while since we've seen you. What have you been doing in the meantime since
I've been at home. There was some time where I had to relax a little bit. Then obviously training, preparation, then coming back to Italy like 1.5 weeks before to have some sim running, some prep for Monza, and now I'm here. So yeah, a bit of chill, a bit of work, a bit of prep, and here we are.
You know, I think the team always want to win every weekend, but the home race is, you know, where you're a driver of the team. I think Ferrari is a perfect example of that. Obviously Prema's not quite Ferrari, but you know, in the junior super series they're more or less the equivalent. So you know, I think it'd be very special to get a home win for them. I haven't seen too many fans in general yet, but I'm hoping there's going to be a few Prema fans around. I think Robert's had to sign a few autographs being with Ferrari and Prema, so hopefully I can get in on that spot. But yeah, I think it always adds a bit of something special, and with the fans here this year compared to last year, it should be awesome.
What have you been up to today already?
Well, we did quite a lot. We did track walk, we did a few interviews, we had lunch, which is very important, and we're here. It's lovely track, it's historical, it's super quick, and I mean, I always liked the track. It was always fun, especially to race, because here you can overtake and you can actually do a proper racing here.
We've got some lovely questions coming in. A lot of people saying hello to you, waving, lots of emojis going on. First Primate says, do you have a chance of racing in F1 next year? The driver market in F1 has been going crazy this week. I imagine you are well aware of that. What's the likelihood? Perhaps maybe not 2022 or maybe 2023? What are we thinking?
To be honest, I don't know. I don't know. I know that my target is to win. Is to win the championship, to win the Formula 2, and then with having such a good result, and hopefully the teams in Formula 1 will gonna appreciate that, notice that, and maybe at some point will put me in the car.
Yeah. Ready to go.
Taxi driver Robert.
Are you gonna leave him a tip up?
Yeah, there? Only a little tip though, depends how good he drives.
Okay, this is not real.
already.
It is 5:20. Remember, we want training time.
So Richard, if you stay there.
I do?
Yeah, and if Joe comes towards you and Richard.
Don't take me with you.
And serious faces, 1, 2, 3.
I'm like a Spider-Man!
I'm sliding now. No, I'm not sliding anymore.
Ah, it depends, you know, that's the weight distribution. As soon as you put a bit weight on your back, that's where you start sliding.
Okay, and go. Nice, cool, and still on, mate.
The interesting thing is how they built it, like, because, you know, it has to be very smooth, and how steep it is, it's quite...
Whereas here, it's you know, the track isn't as technical as Silverstone, but you've got a lot of big braking zones that are very easy to misjudge. And then the racing side of things is much more intense than Silverstone, I would predict. So you know, we haven't raced wheel to wheel for 8 weeks, so that's probably going to be the biggest challenge to get used to. And who knows, we might see some more crashing or some more, you know, lockups or missing, especially down at turn one. We might see a few people missing the chicane, but hopefully I'm not one of them.
How much time there is going to be when we're going to rush the speed lane before we go?
7-8 minutes.
Okay, do you have something very thin, like a student or something like this?
Yeah. Yeah, that's okay.
Oh, well,
Oscar.
Thank you. Yeah. Sounds like okay. I need to go quicker.
You should do one of the new ones.
Yeah, no problem. Yeah, well, I had a bit of understeer on the entries and mid, but okay.
Sweet.
Oscar, can I get you quick for a number one shot?
Yeah.
Sorry, that's
all right. Oh, of course.
Oscar Piastri, pole position, the second pole in a row for you. How was your qualifying session today?
Yeah, it was good. We had a really strong car throughout the whole session, and I think we were quickest after the first set of tyres, and then backed it up again in the second set. So I'm very happy with that, and a big thank you to Prema for a great car again. Yeah, two in a row feels pretty nice. So. It's great to be starting on pole.
It could be any 40 anni, it might be awesome. Oh!
Ça c'est pas un rire, ma cavioli.
Questo è un don tormion.
Un don tormion.
Auguri!
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 Augurissimi!
Ciao!
Good?
Yes, very good.
Hello.
Good morning.
Yeah.
in the gravel.
Oh.
Oh.
You have one left and then
listening. Yeah.
Oh, mate.
Because I thought it was going to be like a 360 and then just keep going. So I went to the left and then he just kept spinning. And he also went to the left, so I was like, I had to slam on the brakes.
Right. Me and Lawson got saved because of that.
Yeah.
Happy birthday! Happy birthday!
Ciao, ciao, ciao!
Ciao, boy!
Easy one.
Name the film.
Obviously, who is recording there?
Oscar Piastri, second win of the year, national anthem of Australia.
What happened?
It doesn't stick.
Ah, yeah.
That's how much glue they put on.
Like even the mechanical
we do it for the passion, not the trophy.
No, we do it. Well, we should do it for both.
Very nice to be able to keep that one off, and yeah, I think we had a very strong race today. We had good pace and survived all the safety car restarts to hold on.
We heard Matt Webber say in the pop family when he came to congratulate you, not bad for a rookie. So not bad for a rookie.
Yeah, you're not wrong. I don't really look at the rookie status that much. I'm going out there to try and win, and I think now I'm in a position in the championship pretty clearly that I'm not just going for rookie glory. I'm trying to win the main championship as well. So.